right. Come on. Come back. Okay. Is that better? Let's see if that's better. Okay. Hello, hello. I just took off my Wi-Fi, and so that might be why, because I'm outside, and I'm on my cell phone service. Hello, yes, we're outside. Okay, and we've got some blue jays calling in the distance. I am enjoying it is a crisp evening, so I'm very excited to do this movement meditation. And so I invite you to set an intention on your end. Everything is Reiki healing energy for your highest good. If it's your first time, hello, my name is Alex. And I do these every Sunday at 8 p.m. Welcome to the Torchbearer community. There's a ton of us that gather every week to do these healings and to receive the energy work, as well as to hold our own torches and gather together to inspire each other and to share love and for this to be a safe space. So like I said, everything is for your highest good. You go as deep as you feel called, and that's all I feel called to say. I'm just gonna go straight into the movement. I'm gonna go into a meditative like state. I'll be popping in and out of the chat, but I'm gonna kind of ignore the chat for the most part. Everything you see me doing is channeling the same energy through my body that is channeling it through yours, as long as you're setting that intention that you're receiving it for your highest good. The moon spirit's burning, which is really a perfect energy for the new moon we just experienced and for everything that's been going on, really providing a little bit of motherly support is what I'm feeling this evening from it, especially for our emotions and for some of the maybe stagnancy or frustration or even major changes that we're going through as a collective. Yes, I hear you. I hear you. Do you hear that? It hasn't stopped, y'all, since I came out. So I matched it today. I went to the, I had a friend message me and call me and say, hey, you want to go to the nail salon? And I'm like, yeah, let's go. So I went and got a mani and pedi done, and I've only done it one other time, but I paint my nails all the time. But I managed to not mess them up. She was like, don't mess them up. I was like, so, but I matched them pretty well to my shirt that I wore today. my toes are the same. Okay. Take a deep breath in. I'm just gonna ground jaw and ground myself. Thank you to those that are sending likes. Thank you for being here. Hello, hello. We're outside, yes. We're gonna move into the candle shop, which I do have a surprise. The candle shop looks a little different. I've been working on it the past couple days. So I'm gonna show y'all and reveal the new candle shop. For some of you, it may be like it looks the same, but for me, it's a lot of changes, but we're gonna move into there. I thought this would be fun to do some of the healing out here first. So get into your heart, get out of your mind, just listen to the music, follow my movements if you feel called, okay? Haven't used it in a long time. Kind of fitting. I would be barefoot for sure, but I just got my nails done on my feet, so I don't want to mess them up. But they went the same that time. We just have to accept that things can't always match, you know? This one's so much heavier. All right, deep breath, y'all. We're in the in-between right now. Gosh, where did I get this? Hold on. It was a gift. I don't remember now, but you can type in like LED staff on Google, and you'll probably find a couple different companies and see which one you feel called to. Because I can't remember what the company was. Okay. Yeah, of course. Too. I think they're finally in sync again. So now when I change it, it should match. One, two.
to lay me down once more, to lay me down with my head in sparkling clover. Let the world go by, all lost in dreaming.
I felt like a mime during that, y'all. That was a...
Better with the lights on, we can play my favorite song.
looking at me, take one shot, two shot, hit deeper, taste sweeter. Good, but it feels wrong. I can last so long. Looking at me, take three shot, four shot, throat heater, get sweeter. It's so hard, but loving me, I'm like a whiskey. You can feel it, it's so strong, but tastes so sweet. There's no love in me, no way to say you need me. But you don't know me, I'm the dark type, forever lonely. It's so strong, but tastes so sweet. There's no love in me, no way.
Thanks for being here, y'all. Wow, 14,000 likes. Wow, geez, y'all. Thank you so much. Sending you so much love. We're about to move inside. I think one more song. But I need just a moment to rest.
Forever lonely, it's so strong, but tastes so sweet. There's no love in me, no way. There's no love in me, there's no love in me.
Need some water. You gonna change the color for me? Blow. Thank you. Thank you. except for your highest good. I'm blasting you with everything we've just built, y'all. It's gonna come at you in a wave, but it'll be a wave that's most conducive. Whoa! Not you sending the wave of music as I'm saying it. Fudge, that was powerful, cool. It's literally exactly how I envisioned it because of the rainbow. Always, you're always on point. Deep breath, y'all. I think we're going one more song. So we're getting deep here. Just follow, just feel, let yourself go wherever you need to for your highest good, okay? I'm flooding the energy in through the phone right now into the palm of your hand. We're gonna cleanse anything not serving your highest good, anything stopping you back from receiving your manifestations, from receiving what is already yours. You're perfect just as you are. You don't have to do anything. We're just holding some love and support for you as you are now. It's the last song. Can you bring on something? Get it together, Spirit. You're the train. Right as the song ends. Literally.
When I die, I don't wanna rest in peace. I wanna dance in joy. I wanna dance in the graveyards, and while I'm alive, I don't wanna be alone. Mourning the ones who came before, I wanna dance with them some more. Let's dance in the graveyards. Gloria, like some other name we kept on calling ya, and waiting for change, but I belong to all of the mystery. All of us, we're meant for the fire, but we keep rising up, walking the wire, so when we go.
Oh my goodness, okay. I think we're ready to go to the candle shop. Are y'all ready to see the new candle shop? Bonk, the horn honked. Spirit agrees. So we're gonna put on this playlist, but we're going to shuffle it. Okay, y'all. Whew. So we're gonna go into the candle shop, okay? Oh, 33 people, so cool. Look, the freaking communication. You heard the train when the freaking song ended, and then you heard the beep when we're like, you wanna go inside? And then Hecate was here and I heard her dogs. They were loud, y'all. How did you feel? Okay. Okay, y'all. Let me stick this in my pocket.
Just like magic. Just like magic. I get everything I want because I attract it.
Okay, y'all, I gotta carry a lot, so. We're on the tripod. We're on an adventure, okay? You just gotta trust me. Follow the torch, okay? You see the torch? I'm holding it in my hand. So you just follow me. Just keep all hands. Hey, put your hand in the vehicle. You're gonna get hurt. I don't want you to get injured, okay? Lovingly, keep your hands. Oh, look, we have a light. Catch your breath, Alex. Never. I'm like, go. Wait, I'm walking into a bush. Hold on. I'm the one lighting our way here. Okay. I attracted middle finger. Okay, hold on. Just like magic. Just like magic. Oh my gosh. Okay. We've made it in. Oh, we've made it inside. Hold on a moment. My house is a little bit of a mess right now. We're gonna pause right here. Okay. Almost ready. If you know me at all, you know I like showmanship. So we have to go through. I gotta change the music to the speaker in there so that when I walk in, it's playing for y'all. Oh, that's not my password. Candle shop. Okay. I should dab my face. Just stare at this wall. Okay. Oh, well, I'll come back for water, okay? Because I don't want to take any more time. All right. I actually think I'm gonna take you off of the tripod for a second, and then I'll get the tripod after I show you. Okay. Wait. Okay, don't peek. Like as if you're controlling this. Oh, something fell. Hold on. Stay there, Nim. Okay. Wait, we've got lots of doors to go through. We're almost there. Oh my gosh, I knocked over a whole tarot deck. We have to do a reading with it. That's a sign. Hold on. Stay there. And like every card I see, oh my gosh, y'all, what the, look at these cards that fell over. Okay. The Devil. The Tower. But we got the Queen of Wands over here. We got Death over here. We've got Temperance. My goodness. The Magician. The Two of Swords. What a reading here on the floor. The Star. Eight of Swords. Six of Swords. Leaving this behind. This is giving me like, look, they're moving beyond the Tower. And also the Devil's way over here. Like, you cannot come. You can't sit with us. That's what that's giving me. And look, the Tower's right here. Underneath that, the Nine of Swords. Completion. We have said no more. See you later. We get in our boat made of this like freaking thing. And we're going to go on to the Star. Look at that. Going to the Star. And then the Queen of Wands to creativity, where we have to face a lot of our inner demons of like, are we worthy? Are we able to do this? Then we kind of start to doubt if our path is correct. Two of Swords. Which way should we really go? Fuck that. We're going to manifest. Excuse my language. We're gonna manifest some new energy. Temperance, boom, death. That's kind of how that goes. You get balance, but you gotta go through the major change. Okay, what a reading. We just broke that down. And what's the one card? Ooh, Ace of Swords, a new mentality. Look, freedom. That's what that means right there. Freedom, self-autonomy, being able to control what decisions you're making, what your ideas, bringing them to fruition, especially since that Devil energy was all the way over there. That fucker couldn't come. Okay. Hold on. I might be lacking oxygen. All right, I'm going to turn this fan up higher. All right. I'm just being funny, y'all. Okay, don't worry. All right. I'm closing the door gently this time so that I don't give us another reading. the Devil can't sit with us, exactly. Okay. Oh, let me go this way. Oh, thank you. Okay. Let me set this. All right. Are y'all ready to see? I mean, for some of you, you're like, I don't understand why there's all this drama going on right now. I've changed the candle shop a little bit, and now I have a new angle, and I want to introduce you to the new candle shop, because this is a new beginning here. Here's we change it, and what's funny is I painted this door 1 year ago today. I didn't plan that, but I happened to finish the candle shop today, and redoing everything, and then I saw my time hop that 1 year ago today, I painted this door. So, really cool. This is the entryway to Spirit Guide Apothecary. It's an ethereal door. So, when you shop, you always knock on this door energetically. Yeah, isn't that right, Luna? She's agreeing. She's like, you excited? She wants people to be more excited. And she said, turn the AC on. Thank you, Luna. I hear you. Let's turn that thing down. Look at that. 74. We're going to 70. That's what we're doing. Okay. Sorry, y'all. Sorry. Okay. Action. Spirit Guide Apothecary. And then we open the door. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Nothing looks different yet, but it does at the same time. This is the new wall. I've moved everything over. All of this went over, but I'm gonna show you up close. So this is gonna be the new angle that we're gonna probably be going with here on when I'm doing my lives with y'all. And so I made it to where I could kind of, this is kind of my working area, and I never really showed y'all this side that often because it was really, oftentimes I'm doing lots of like, you know, my apothecary stuff up here. So now I've got all the candles up here. And I've got extra storage for herbs. All the guides hang all around. These here are mostly all of these are the ones that Todd had done. And there's that other door over there. That's the same. But, and then I've got all storage over here. This is all storage stuff where I've got candle inventory. I moved all the candle inventory over here. And then I added some art pieces up there. These are all my pieces over here. And then moving over into the area that's a little more like been redone. All this has been redone up here and done up real cute. I'm so happy. I hope y'all like it. And it also has all of my stuff that's available on my shop up here. So these are my oracle cards. You can see, oh, thank you for the gifts. You can see the oracle cards right here that I have on display. I've got my little witch holding my wand there. She's so cute. Look at her. Or them, actually. I do actually think that they're they, them. And so I've got my hit clips here. I've got my otter bath salt. I've got candles, which I actually don't have those up on my shop right now, but I do have them, pillar candles for like in-person stuff. And if y'all are really interested, I'll get them up there for y'all. I've got my soaps up here and the spell jars, both the dream and the solar energy jars. So both which have Reiki. Everything has Reiki healing energy. This is the Fox Spirit Guide soap right here. I've also got little frog tea light candles. I've got some peace and serenity incense from the Deer Spirit Guide. I've got two of these jars left. It comes with a charcoal disc for you to light the incense in a fireproof safe dish with some salt and stuff on the bottom. You definitely need to be safe when doing that. I also have matches and oils available for anointing, as well as the new wax melts, as well as I gotta add these to the shop too. These are new from the last month's deep dive box, the rabbit, or this month's actually. And then I've got the restoration lip balm. I've got the aura cleansing spray. We've got soaps and bath bombs here. Now I've got my little crystals here so that I can grab crystals more easily for when I'm doing healings with y'all. I have my whole little collection here to use, as well as some other art pieces that I have that I've done here. I've got my oracle cards and my tarot decks over here at easy access to use for y'all. I also have storage for stuff down here. Down here I've got my books and stuff that I use. I'm giving y'all a full-blown tour, okay? I've got my books and stuff that I use for research. I've got my book, my personal book of shadows here for my spirit guide stuff, which I make these for y'all sometimes. This holds all the deep dive pages. Let's open it up. You unwind it. All made from eco-friendly materials and upcycled. And it holds all my deep dive pages for all the months prior in here. I didn't, some of them are not put in there because I'm a bit of a chaotic witch and I put things everywhere. So, but you can move all the pages around because it's a 3-ring binder, as well. I love using it for all the deep dive pages. So, and a couple of y'all have it. And then I've got my actual book of shadows. And then here's my little area that's more, I made this in college. She's a shadow puppet, witch, and, actually, Todd helped me make her a lot. He helped me because I was struggling with her. You can tell the hand looks completely different. That's Todd. Todd did that hand. That's a real good hand. cutting that out is not easy, I'll tell you. But it takes a lot of patience. And then I've got more little storage area. I don't even know what I'm going to put down here because look, I cleared out so much space. I moved all the printers. I'm super happy with it. And yeah, that's Spirit Guide Apothecary now. Everything is kind of shifted. And oh, I guess I can show you, I'll show you, and I also added this little table here. This is from my treehouse. My mom made it for me when I was little, and it went on top of my treehouse at our house, and so I now have it here. I've had it for a while now, and I've wanted to hang it. Oh, I also have some fox necklaces available on my website with some lapis chrysocolla crystal on it. This came in the sun box. And then I got a little working station here. I renovated this whole little, apothecary station. Yeah. That's a little messy in there. But I've got more herbs down here. I've got some full moon water. Here's the death and rebirth oil that I send y'all. I should be careful because I've got some surprises in there. Let me not show you all that. Hold on. So, and then now I've got easy access for all of my magical herbs that I use on the regular. I've got all that right up here, easy to go. And then this is stuff for packaging material for y'all when I'm sending out packages. And then I've got all the extra candles down here. So that's it, y'all.
I think I can finally turn everything around now. Let me flip the camera back. Okay. Yay! Welcome to the new Spirit Guide Apothecary. I mean, the same, but new Spirit Guide Apothecary. I'm super excited, and I maybe have to cover that because I forgot I have rose petals there drying. Okay, let me plug in. I'm on to the next thing of... Okay, and I gotta plug this in, and then we'll be set up back in the candle shop. Okay? You used to have a treehouse too? That's so cool. The round light, did you buy that? Which one? This one right here? Yes. If that's what you're talking about, yes. I did. I have a new ring light, if that's what you're asking. I do have a new ring light, if you, and it's bright. This is at 22%. 22%, and it's huge. Look at my head. Huge. Now, I'll tell you, though, for some reason, it don't like to be straight, which me either, but I kind of need that for, there we go. You know, you guys are a little crooked here. My other one was great at that, but this one's, like, heavy duty. Okay. Hold on. We got to find the right angle here, y'all, okay? We're going to have to work for a second here because this is literally, I wanted to have set this up, but I did not have the time because I went to go get my nails done, you know? I love that I'm cracking y'all up. You guys know I like to have fun. Okay. And make people laugh. Making people laugh has always been one of my favorite things to do. Okay, I think I'm liking that vibe there. What's that look like? How's that look, y'all? I think we've got the moon here. Okay, I've cooled off so I can turn this fan down. Okay. Ooh, I have to change things. This is different. This is so different. I also moved this whole section in the middle. This way and that way. So I now have a lot more room to walk in here. So now when I'm working in the candle shop with y'all, I'll be able to kind of space out a little bit better. I think I like this. I mean, I wish I could get, I want to get that, but then I lose some of the candles and I can't go any further back. So I don't want to lose any of the candles. I might have to move the candles a little bit because that lamp is too pretty to lose. You know? I really want to be like right there. Okay, let's see here. Now, but what if I go, I could just kind of shift a little. Oh, I might have solved it. If I just go a little farther right. Uh-oh. Now we're crooked. Like I told you, there's going to be some deciding here. Nope, that didn't change anything. It looked like it was going to change something. All right, we accept it. We move on, right? We're there. That's the perfect. And I'll shift. I can shift them this way a little bit. You don't have to be. Oh, see, look. I feel like I'm topsy-turvy. I feel like I'm topsy-turvy right now. Hold on a minute. And then I also would like you to see the fan a little less, but because I feel like it's going to be a little distracting for you, you know? There we go. Is that banner? I think that's banner. Okay. Am I stranded on an island? Okay, y'all. I'm sorry. You're going to have to give me just a second to ground real quick. I'm going to go wash my hands and just ground myself really quickly. And I'm actually going to change t-shirts. Thank you for being here. I know tonight's a little bit all over the place, and that kind of actually is pretty normal. But thank you for being here. My name's Alex, if it's your first time. I hope you come every Sunday. We do energy work, normally a little more traditionally here in the candle shop, and more focused in on stuff. And I'm not sure yet. It's 9, so I may do a little more energy work. After I ground myself, I'm going to see what I feel. We may do a collective reading first, and then see if I feel called to do a collective healing or not. And if not, then I definitely want to pick some candles for people tonight. I think it'd be fun to do some readings with candles tonight and see if we can get a good group of like little readings and stuff going. 2.2 likes. Mwah, I love it. I've landed in paradise. Thank you. Enjoy the new view, but actually... No, I'm saving the how. I'm going to go ground myself like I want. Okay.
I'm back. All right.
Okay, I think, two, yes.
I want, let's see here. I wanna make sure that I can still read the chat too. I think I need to raise the height because I changed it. Ever lost in Wonderland. Nope, I think it's good there. Here it is. We're gonna go a little higher. There we go. And then now, I love the candles up there. It's so cute. They do sort of blend in a little bit. And I do think that Spider-Man is gonna have to move. I love him, but he's gonna have to live somewhere else so that you can fully, oh, you're crooked as heck now. But so that you can, I don't understand what you're crooked for. I'm sorry, y'all. This is Lost in Wonderland by Miley Cyrus. Wonderland with our head above the wall clouds. All right, I'm going to find a new place for Spider-Man and the chakras at some point here. Oh, maybe for now it can live right there. Perfect. All right. There'll probably be some changes because I'm still sort of like moving some things about and I might move the angle again or see if I can kind of bring some of the candles this way a little bit so that I can kind of shift like I had wanted. But this is the new, I still wish, I can't believe they got rid of my little being able to make it big, but could you come at it from the side to get closer? You want to be closer to me? Yeah, see, that's what I was wondering too. Am I too far? Let's see. Maybe if I just come super close and forget the, we just leave the candles here. And there. Yes, we do. You want to be closer? Me too. I was feeling far too. I was like, I can't even read y'all. But we're just going to do like this then. I think that's better, right? Maybe I can even, there we go. Okay, now let me see what your angle is. See, like when I stand here, I think I look crooked, but it's hard to shift it on over here without, there we go. Now I think that's a little bit better. And I think this has to go like that. All right, and I think that that's good. I don't wanna see any of the candles that aren't made or not finished. There we go. Better? Yeah? Yeah, what are we feeling? It still feels a little weird. Like I do feel, the height is kind of nice. Like you're a little taller than me now. And I do like you being able to see my workspace here because there is gonna be times that I'm gonna be doing readings and more things more visible for y'all. And so I'd like to make it more easy and flow so that you can see what I'm doing and if I'm doing charm castings and things like that. So it's better, good, okay. And I think I can join, I'm gonna see about joining TikTok real quick over here because I have TikTok over on this. And then I would solve all of the problems and I'd be able to read, I'll be able to read at the same time because I can still see, but I'm so sad that TikTok got rid of the big chat box. I don't know where it's gone. I've even tried Googling it. So okay, y'all, I think I really do feel called to do a reading and a howl in the first reading and howl in the space. And I actually think I am gonna throw on the violet flame just to kind of cleanse, maybe do a little smoke cleansing. This is our first gathering back inside the apothecary. I very intentionally wanted to start tonight outside of it and sort of bring us in. So I appreciate those that stayed patient and kind of hung out. I love you as a collective that stays here. I feel you every time and I see you time and time again. And if it's your first time here, because sometimes there are a couple of you that haven't been when we're in this small group, then welcome. I hope you'll join more often. I love gathering with y'all every week, and I came up to do something, but now I don't remember. So let me start tapping in to see what deck I want to pull from. Oh, Violet Flame, that's what it was. Thank you, Spirit. enhance effects. And also, y'all, I forgot, I gotta turn it on mirror mode. Oh my goodness, that's gonna be so different. Okay. That is how the candle shop should look, because that is now everything in, like, there you go. You can actually read Alex's place. Thank you. It was turned on violet flame. Y'all got me. Y'all, Mercury retrograde, and I also my brain today has been a little bit on rest mode, which is great, but it just means that I'm not as I think a little bit brighter is better. That's a little brighter though. Y'all, we're just working through the, figuring out the right setup. All right, violet flame is on. Yay! We're working through here. I want the little turtle to be visible for you. I've got these sound bowls here, and I actually think I am gonna move this one here. Nope, I'm gonna go here. Yep, thank you, Spirit, I gotcha. Okay. Let's see here. All right, let me get that. I've got the candle here. I'm gonna get this smoke going real quick to cleanse it. Looks amazing. Oh, yay, thank y'all, thank y'all. Thank you for the follow. Jan, I appreciate, I think that's what it says. I'm getting my app up so that I can, I don't wanna, no, I don't want interest. Skip. Swipe up. Start watching. Okay. Okay. Enjoy my experience. Got it. Okay. I'm getting up on. Here I am. I'm in the live! Alright, now I'll do this from more. No, now on. Okay, love it. Looks amazing. I can read y'all. And it's not. Oh, I see what I'm hearing. There's been some signs coming in. Hello, hello to the past. I did it. All right, I got you, Spirit. We're back in. It's like it's coming out with the, y'all, I'm just following, okay? I'm just following here. All right, now I can see the chat. Awesome. Okay, we're set up. Okay. All right, let's howl on three, y'all. We've got the moon spirit guide going. I actually think I want to read you its messages first. So let's grab it for the very first time. We're going to grab the candle from up here and read a message. So we're going to move the unicorn over and bring the moon. So moon spirit guide represents
Cycles and Shadows, and I went with lavender essential oil. I also chose to not do an herb topping, unlike every other candle, because I wanted the cleansing energy of also you being able to place in any intention, as well as it looks like a moon when it's just a candle. So I thought that was really cool. So that was the design I decided to go with. And so here is the moon candle up close. Let me actually... Cycles and Shadow, lavender essential oil. You see all the beautiful purple and violet. We're going to read all the messages here on the side to activate the energy. We already have the candle burning, means we've already lit the torch and activated the moon spirit, letting it know that we'd like to work with its energy with intention for our highest good. And so when we read these, when I read these, I'm saying we because I'm putting the intention that you're also reading these intentions, and it's assisting you in the way that is most beneficial to you for your highest good, okay? So you apply and imply the things that are necessary for you right now, and really hold space for that. And what you'd like, Mother Moon, is what this spirit guide has been referenced. And you actually saw, I'm not going to show it again on camera because I don't have permission to, but one of my good friend's moms inspired this candle, and it's a really big dedication to her and to Gliboblastema. That's really hard to say, but in her foundation and in honor for her. So this candle is really big, and I think it's I just saw her the other day actually to celebrate her birthday yesterday, and Jordan, my good friend, and so this is a lighting of this candle, and we're inviting her energy in. And when I saw her on camera, I kind of felt her. She's a big part of like the energy work of these candles. At least every time I'm working with this moon guide, I've attached that energy, and I've seen how this guide has shown up with the collective. That doesn't mean that's how you have to use it. You can use it in a way that resonates for you. But this has been a guide that's been very healing. It's also been very divinely associated with the divine feminine and also with motherly energy. Now, divine feminine, I'm always going to say it. I know some of you have probably heard it a million times, but divine feminine is not femininity and not feminine like female. We're talking about divine feminine energy and divine masculine energy that we hold within. And it's more just a construct for us to understand the representation of the dualistic energies that we've assigned. Now, we're a mix of those energies, okay? Our masculine and feminine is really way more intertwined and complex and goes over to each side way more than we give it credit, or than at least that I think that we often have in the spiritual community, or even in, especially in society, because then we've gotten into where we have assigned masculinity and femininity to gender and even to energy in a way. Because energy speaking to femininity does not mean that it is also from someone that identifies as female or someone that identifies as male. Because we also have so much of a spectrum within that. So when I worked with this guide as well as the sun, it really reflected so much of that. And that was really cool because another, I guess I'm feeling called to share this. I hope, Jordan, you're okay with it. But another big thing about Millie was her name, was that she was super big into helping communities, especially the LGBTQ plus community, because her daughter and a bunch of her close friends and people that she cares for, and also just it was a big thing for her. And so that's something that I think when I'm working with this candle, it's interesting that even shows me a new reflection on this divine feminine energy, and how she's showing up and how that energy has shown up in this collective here when working with this guide. So all of that to say, we already have the candle going, but let's read the message of the moon spirit. Cycles and Shadow. I actually think I want to howl first, so on three. One, two, three. Moon spirit guide represents cyclicity, ebb and flow, emotion, darkness, and maternal energy. It's the divine feminine energy found in everyone, regardless of gender. Moon connects us to our subconscious, which links us to our empathic and intuitive selves. Moon helps you dive into shadow work, unafraid and in trust. The moon carries an air of mystery and calm. Its magnetic nature inspires vulnerability, nudging us to go inward and allow ourselves to feel our emotions. In the darkness, it shines its light on thought patterns that no longer serve us, so that we learn self-acceptance and self-love. Moon wants us to let go and creatively express our soul essence. Moon spirit. Yay! Fitting for everything going on in the collective energy. Okay. Let me just do a final swipe. Everything is infused with love and new beginnings. Yay! Thanks for being a part of my little cleansing ritual and new beginning here. I appreciate it so much. Okay, I do think I want to do a little channeled energy just towards y'all and towards us here, and then we'll pull some cards, shall we? I think I'm going to just go into, I do think I want to skip. Alexa, skip. Because I'm feeling the call, the lull, so let me just find the right frequency here. She's in a new spot. Thank you, madam, for holding my wand. Or sir, madam and sir. All right. Just giving it a second. Grounding my energy, letting all my ruminating thoughts settle. The noise. Yes, she moved. She's here now. All right. Deep breath in. Breath in. Relax those shoulders. Release the tension from your jawline. Let the tongue fall. Let the face relax. One. Two. Three. feel like they're a part of like the healing way more actively now because their candles are so like prevalent. So confirmation. I don't know if I can do it with the ball. Ow! It's harder. I love that y'all always laugh with me. Some arm movements over here in this new space. Things are in different areas. My arms are also a little like jello because, like I said, that staff is heavy and I haven't used it in a while. So, and when the lady massaged my arms today at the nail salon, she knew. She laughed. She giggled because I kind of was like my eyes rolling back. I was like, oh my god, it's so amazing. Yep, I'm gonna grab that right there. Thank you. You don't need that. Thank you. Just look at the pretty nail. Pretty nail. Yep, thank you. Actually, if you will, if you feel called, call up your inner child and envision them handing over a bouquet of rotten flowers. These flowers, they've been holding on to them and they're just carrying them around and they're going to give those rotten flowers to me. Thank you, little one. Thank you. You don't need that anymore. You can go pick some new flowers. Yes, yes, pick some new ones, some pretty daisies. Yes, okay. Thank you for the rotten flowers. I love them. I'm going to go and put them on the fire and they're going to give us so much warmth. They've done so much good for helping you. Thank you. Yep, give them over. These rotten flowers, I don't know, but they're here they are and you're giving them to me. Okay, we're done. Thank you. Moon, would you mind burning these flowers to me? Thank you. Thank you so much. They are beautiful. They are beautiful. Don't worry, they're beautiful flowers. They're going to go back to be reborn. You'll see them again. You'll see them again. The pink one is nice. See the pink one? A lightsaber. I was doing, oh, outside. I got you. I already moved on. Alright. I think we are done with that. Thank you, Spirit. Okay. Do you have any more flowers? Because I'm last call for flowers.
Alright, there's one right there. Stay in your seat, okay? We don't want you falling out now. I'm gonna grab that flower there. Alright, there we go. Thank you, thank you. Alright, Spirit. Thank you.
That's a good session. We've already used the big bell. I don't feel called to it often.
I'm sorry, I know it's loud.
Alright, we're done.
Whew, still ringing in my ears, but I'll tell you that thing. Did you feel it? Did you feel the energy settle? Did you feel... I felt stagnancy lift, which was really nice. I felt, I actually would say decay, like stagnancy is really like, you know, like a puddle that has been sitting, like rotten flowers. Like I literally just described it as rotten flowers, and that's what I felt. So that's what it is, and that's what it was. And spirit, the moon was like so lovingly like receiving. It almost felt like a burial like offering. So that was kind of interesting. And then the bell, and even like, yeah, it was super cool. So thank you for being here. Oh wait, hold on, I gotta look over here. My inner child was really emotional about that. Oh, I thank you for being vulnerable enough to go there. Give your inner child a hug. I'm actually, if you will, I'm actually gonna bring y'all some flowers. One second, hold on. I have something somewhere. All right, if you'll pull your little inner children back, I'm coming with flowers. It's really unique, but I hope you like it. I also added sticks. I thought that would be fun, you know, like and different. And make, if you wanted, you could like whip it out and make it into a wand, like this one. So, yeah. And this one was made with love. You can carry it as long as you'd like. And you can add to it. Here you go. Joining right now, I was like, what is this guy doing? He's just holding sticks up to the camera. We're all in our own little like inner child holding these flowers. Thank you so much. That's how I feel. Like, really? The fuck? Take the flowers. Okay. There you go. I'm crying him with the sticks. If they don't like, if you don't like my sticks, go buy a drone. I know where my sticks come from. I source them myself. My yard. Trees gave them to me. I asked permission. This one's from a butterfly bush. From my mom's yard. Because I steal sticks from there too. When I snap my fingers, you are fully grounded and cleansed of anything not serving your highest good. 3, 2, 1.
I look pretty good hanging upside down with my tree playing with sunlight and water. Yeah. Beep, beep. Good job, y'all.
Beautiful healing.
Thank you for being here. I feel honored to have done that first healing here. The frequency feels different. In the shop, in the room, I hope you feel it. I hope you're feeling reinvigorated, re-inspired. Because even though some of the collective energies can feel a little stagnant right now, especially with some of the frustrations going on with communication with Mercury retrograde, it can also really show, it can also be an opening. And that's exactly what the music just did. It gave me an opening to be heard. So recognize that, that not everything is by the timing of everybody else, and what someone studies or what works for someone won't always be what works for you. So even when I tell you, this is what, this is that, this is this, you say, yeah, that sounds great. And then you take it in and you say, you know what? That actually doesn't sound that great. Throw that shit out. And you say, actually, no, I'm going to keep this part, and that part applies. And this is just really like grounding you back into presence, because you're discerning your own wisdom. And this is what you should be doing through your whole life, and what you are doing during your whole life. It's just that you are often telling, we are often telling ourselves the story that we are not in that deciding lane, not in the driving seat of our life, not the artist of our canvas. This is where we're choosing. There, you can't stop pain. You can't stop grief. You can't stop that from happening. But you can move out of suffering. We can move out of that and into pleasure. And where our focus does go does make things grow. So as we shift that focus more and more, doesn't mean that that's going to be the only thing that changes your life. You can change your focus all day long, but if there's still circumstances around you that are shining a light on why your focus isn't reality, you're going to have lessons and things to deprogram in order to get to the desired outcome or the place you're focusing on, the joy that you're focusing on. You can't hide a broken heart with a new coat of paint. So, that's interesting. Right by my back. I backed up into the key. Okay, so I feel like I want to pull some cards now. Okay, I don't know. I'm gonna leave that. I'm actually going to use some Dreamweaver Tarot. The Emperor on the bottom, it's been a while since I've used this. And I always like to kind of peek where it left off, because I never know when it's going to be a while. Sometimes I get obsessed with the deck. And so, Page of Vessels. All right. The masculine energy inside of yourself. And that also can mean that more people outside of you. This is what's coming up here. Okay, so instead of looking at it as like, okay, the divine masculine is going to be more assertive. They're going to bring me more messages of love and clarity and communication, which is interesting, because this can even be signifying that someone might be trying to open up communication doors again. Now, reasons behind could mean a multitude of things. Okay, we're ready for that. Seven of Stones, the Page of Vessels yet again in reverse, and Judgment. So,
I'm actually going to show them to you upright so you can see them. Seven of Earth. This is a really pretty deck. That's why I'm giving you some time. Think they'll accept you, I promise they can. Be who you are and fuck what they think. I actually want to pull more before I go in anywhere into the message, because what's coming up is kind of interesting, and the song was kind of fitting, but I want to get more. Let's see here. I'm feeling called to this. Another tarot deck, actually. So let's go with that. The Guardian of the Night Tarot. Without darkness, there is no light. I lost you for a moment, y'all. Uh, low battery mode, and I was saying how there's a lot of emotions. I don't know what you last heard, but Ace of Cups, there's a lot of emotions coming to the surface, and it makes sense because of the Moon card we're dealing with here. Now we have the King of Swords. We have the Three of Pentacles, and I'm feeling called to the bottom of the deck, which is the Two of Swords. Interesting. One more deck. All right. This is it, though. This is the last one, and I'm feeling this direction. Oh, I know what it is. We're going to read it, too. Okay. One of my favorites. Mystic Art Medicine Oracle Cards. The medicine in this art here is so powerful. I love it. So this is going to be the final revealer here. One card. Actually, I see that. One second. I'm going to lose you. We're a little... We're keeping both. Skip. Oh, I'm feeling a different playlist, so hold on. Let me think about what I want. We're gonna leave it. Okay. Seven of Stones in reverse, Page of Vessels in reverse, Judgment. You're moving on from, like I said, stagnation and miscommunication. From being unheard in a way that actually creates unjust... hold on, let me be clear here. Unjust standpoints. Because it's placing you in positions where you're forced to be no matter what. There's so much dualistic energy going on here with the Two of Swords, and with this Seven of Swords being in, or Seven of Stones being in reverse. I feel like it has to do with passions and what you've been, foundations and what you've been building, okay? Like what you've been working towards. You've hit this moment where with the Two of Swords, it's reflecting that the indecision itself is where you're now having to stand in this gray area, if you will. Follow me here, hold on. Three of Pentacles here. You're starting to look for new people to work with. You're starting to look for new opportunities. You're starting to look for new help. But the thing is, this is why the Page of Vessels is in reverse, because I'm getting that you're constantly placing your emotional fulfillment, and this is all of us collectively here, so only take what resonates, okay? This could even be just one specific situation that's coming up here, okay? It has to do with something very foundational, though, so it could be a core belief. It could be something materialistic. It could actually be coworkers, because I'm getting that there's this, like, either a startup or some sort of revving of the engine is what they're showing me. And the Page of Vessels is the thing is that you're mixing, mixing business with pleasure. But I'm getting it's more of like a overpouring of your emotional energy, and it's because you care so much. I think that when we start to awaken ourselves to like the love of being able to see that there's right and wrong within everything, we start to also be very forgiving, but also very cutthroat. This is the Two of Swords here, where we're starting to blind ourselves and we're starting to go into moments of cutthroat energy, judgment, casting judgments. This is where Judgment card is here. And like I said, it's placing you on this, I don't want to use the word pedestal, but with this King of Swords here, it sure is looking like one, but it's an earned one. Like, it's a well-deserved one, and that's the thing. You're this King of Swords here. You're this owl sitting on top of this sword. Like, you've done the work to see yourself. Amen. We've done the work to see ourselves as this in control, yet not needing to control the control, but being able to flow within the states of being. And this is riding the highs and riding the lows, but with presence, intention, love, compassion, and consciousness at your forethought. This is you not allowing others' thoughts to sway you, but actually standing at the crossroads, with poise and with contemplation, because yeah, I'm here at this crossroads, but I choose to stand here. I don't have to be forced into a decision. That's where I start to get into judgment of my journey. I start to get back into fear-based mentalities. Thank you, Spirit. I'm seeing it now. And I'm hearing that this is where you're also giving over. It's like the Page of Vessels is a very young energy, but with it being in reverse here, I'm getting like falling into like ways you used to fulfill yourself emotionally before. So this could be like having a couple too many drinks, because that's how you used to like let off your steam before. Or like, I mean, and then kind of letting yourself like speak way too much, and your throat chakra becomes too active because it's coming from a place of insecurity or a place of really blurred vision in a way. And the reason why I'm bringing up alcohol is because there's so much having to do with the vase here, and also with so much swords energy. It doesn't have to be alcohol, but it is also calling to us the things that we turn to when we are in the dark are a lot more on the cliff than they are when we're in the light. Okay, I hope that I'm making sense for the people that this message is for. If you're confused, the message isn't for you. Meaning that when you are on that moment of diving deep into your shadow work and really collecting these pieces and fragments of yourself that have been shunned away and judged so much and so harshly, that when you're turning to a small thing that feels innocent or has felt innocent in the past, i.e. to this inner teenager, this Page of Vessels that's coming up, it spirals you into a thought form where you become very stagnant within the dualism. And I know that this is hard, because I think that I'm also resonating with some of this. This is kind of hard to hear. When we get stuck in the dualism of something, we get bogged down into thinking that we've figured out a puzzle. And it's very easy for us to look at our journey and think, okay, this is this puzzle piece, and now this puzzle piece goes here, and then this puzzle piece goes here. And then you get excited because you've built the whole frame, and now you think, oh, okay, this is what this is going to look like, this is what the puzzle's going to look like, and suddenly, what you thought was going to be a rolling landscape of hills is really a piece of rubble that you have that is then being rebuilt and restructured, and oh, okay, I didn't even see that puzzle piece there. And this is why, when you're this King of Swords, when you have become clear with what your desires are and also clear with your intention that you're putting out, you don't get so caught up in if the received is correct, because you can only find what's correct for you in that moment. For example, for me, I always struggled to want to hold on to my knowledge to where I could hold these words of wisdom and just grasp them at any time. But because I was working so diligently my whole life and resisting my innate energy of flow, my innate sort of, ADHD, mind a minute, mile a minute, not gonna say the right word always, but that innately freed me, because I didn't see power in that, and I do now. I do. And anybody that's starting their journey, especially spiritually, and I challenge you, especially because language is so limiting and we've learned language in so many ways that are very constricted to where and how and what you learn, not to mention just the way that you perceive your reality, because we're all creating our own reality, though we're all moving independently and individually yet operating in the same reality. Weird, right? So at the same time, we're creating new pathways. So I'm gonna leave it there. I think that I got woohoo enough, which you know I love to, because here we are with freedom, and what are we free? And I forgot, because I talked about shadow work, and I love it, because that's exactly right, because I forgot that this was the shadow card. Yeah, here it is. And look at this beautiful contrast. Man, I thank you, Spirit. The duality, exactly what we were saying, y'all. This is everything right here, what we pulled in the beginning here, which is freedom and shadow. The last two cards I wanted to read, I'm looking at it and I'm seeing this light and this shadow. And we were talking about all of those aspects and what we're casting judgments on and deciding what is light and what is shadow even. It's kind of coming up here as well. And how when we're in the darkness and we're discerning these fragments and these pieces, we don't want want a lot. This is why the hermit mode is very important as well, because hermit mode allows you to quiet your mind away from the voices outside of yourself and even the voices inside. It takes some time to quiet yourself from those voices so that you can really dive in and hear the voice that's coming. And I will tell you, it's not all happening consciously, because what do you do consciously? Not very much. You don't do very much consciously, right? We're doing so much unconsciously. Even me shaking my hand as I'm talking in my little head, it's doing it all subconsciously. I'm not saying shake your head and make this more poignant. No, it's just happening. So this is the same aspect when we're working with shadow and light aspects of ourselves. They're operating. They're so intertwined within our system. And there's many ways of which we can operate and work on those things, just like in life, right? I could look at it magically. If that resonates for you, we could talk about it magically and working at your system in a magical way. We could look at it through the chakra system, Vedic astrology or Vedic practices, where we're looking at the different energy points, which has really resonated for me. And if that's something that has really resonated, if you thought, oh yeah, energy centers, that makes sense, or we have different points of our body that things pull to, and it's really, when you look at it, it's like our veins, and they all operate to like different things, like your heart, your brain, your lungs, like it's the same concept, right? But explore, because you have way more than that. Just like we have all these little things that make up just my finger to make me unique, right? My fingerprint is mine. It's the same concept, and our energy systems are really set up very individually and very uniquely. And so there, you have way more energy centers and things going on. And so all of these like constructs that we've discovered are very helpful and very beneficial. But we want to remind ourselves that what our real journey is here is to come back to presence, to come back to just yourself, and that knowing you are, no matter how you are already exactly where you're supposed to be, how you're supposed to be. And that's quite frustrating to hear. And I'll tell you, so many times I would bang my head against the wall of, I'm here, this is what I have to be. But I've done X work, and I've done Y work, and this is why I'm moving in this direction. Why didn't this work out in the way that I foresaw? But then I ground myself back into my meditative practices. And if you're feeling a lull, go back to the beginning, go back to a journal entry, if you're a creator, go back to a TikTok from from a year ago. If you're someone that just posts on social media, go back to some posts from a year ago and read what you were talking about, read what you were looking, and see what the photos were. And maybe you'll see things, oh yeah, I look older, oh well, maybe I gained a little chunky roll right here and I didn't have that a year ago. And and this is another thing, our bodies are also very communicative, and we've lost such a disconnect. I'm kind of on some rants tonight, I'm sorry. But we have such a disconnect with our mind, our heart, and our body. And this is really our body, mind, and soul, which is our heart, right? Body, mind, and soul. And so when we're working to unify some of these energies and really honestly get out of dualistic thinking, because that's something that is very easy to be this ping pong of bouncing back and forth between right and wrong, someone being on this part of their journey. It's so easy. You scroll on a TikTok and you see someone and you're like, that's not the way I do it. I don't resonate with that at all. So instantly we get into a moment of judgment of thinking that they don't know what they're talking about. They don't know what they're doing. And the thing is that, you know, because we're a capitalistic society, we're very trained to be constantly looking with these star systems in our mind. Okay, rating. We're constantly rating. Swipe left, swipe right, swipe left, swipe right. But then when we recognize that we're all humans and going through this really crazy experience, let alone an experience where collectively we know that we've all shared in at least one collective trauma at this point right now, which there's many more, but like one collective trauma of going through COVID and having to experience such a disconnect of humanity, yet at the same time going through a big connection of self and a reawakening of self, which has happened so many places all over the world. And it's why so much is shifting, but this is where so much has already been shifting, and also so much is because you're shifting when you're moving things around. This took me 2 days just to rearrange this candle shop, and all I did was like move some candles over here, move some things over here, but figuring out where I wanted things. I'm a very visual person too, and so moving things to where it needed to go helped me. And so this is again to the lesson of letting things have their pacing, letting people have their pacing, letting situations have their pace, but still discerning where standing up for yourself and moving forward confidently and continuing to maintain boundaries and healthy mainframes and being conscious and aware and having mindfulness practices and all of those aspects can be very beneficial and helpful and supportive on this journey in which you're moving towards that, right? Okay, I'm gonna read the cards. We'll read Shadow and Freedom, which clearly we're moving beyond. We're moving beyond. Look at the Shadow card. We're wrapping up here. I'm going to wrap up here for the reading. And then we have Freedom. All right. So I'm going to read the Shadow card first. And they came out together. Creation's child. Prepare yourself for the ultimate flight on the tail of a dragon. Fly through the dungeon into the light. Know thee, O child of thy heritage. Know ye are truly the spirit of light. Ye darkness, O ye have taught me to resist thee not and send thee into heaven's flight. In the cropped image of creation's child, you see a shadowy figure coming down a dark stairway. I'm actually going to move forward so that you can actually... Inflamed with red-hot fire, dark energy is entering through the top of his head, sympathetic of negative thoughts. Old rickety stairs with overgrown roots lead the shadowy figure. There is no getting over. The only way is through. Yet healing, flowing waters in blue spread over the roots. You see all the water? And down the stairs. One flower on the top, right up there, lingers to bring transformation and light into the shadow. Many people following a spiritual path do their darndest to stay away from what we call the shadow. Y'all, this is literally everything I was reading. I mean, I know I was channeling it, but like that's pretty cool because everything I was saying, how when you're going to those real depths, and this message isn't for everyone because I would advise like not to go in that this deep as we're talking into shadow work if you haven't already done a little shadow work before. And I want to also challenge, okay, so like this is shadow work is one of those things that is really not oftenly identified and not oftenly discussed, because one thing is it's very unique, just like the spiritual journey. And so I love that there are certain things that people don't just go straight to speaking about, because it can be very dangerous when we're working with certain aspects, especially with the shadow, because you're confronting the parts of yourself that you don't like, that you think society doesn't like, that you think aren't worth anything, the parts of you that you've shoved in a corner and said you don't deserve to exist. And even though you've done it consciously sometimes, most of the time it's going to be things that you don't even realize, like, you know, consciously for me being loud, that's something I've always not liked and I've always resisted, but I have done shadow work to be able to accept and not be in this angry state of like, yeah, I'm a loud person. I grew up, my family's loud. If you come around my family, everybody's loud. I'm Cuban. It's just part of me. My voice was meant to be powerful. I'm sorry. Like, you're gonna hear me from down the street, like, so, and I have had to do work with that to be able to accept that part of myself, but also know that that's something that is often used as a way to quiet you, and often isn't about me. It's a person that is experiencing that it's about them. And just because I was probably unmasked at the time and not really paying attention to my volume or to social cues of the environment, then that led to those sort of reactions, right? But that doesn't mean that that was wrong. That means that I was wrong, or that me being in that moment, being in joy or being loud, was wrong. That's a moment of shadow work, right? Uncovering that. It can be done through journaling. It can be done right now. We just did it. I just talked about it more. And just in doing so, I'm doing more shadow work, which is what's cool, because you don't have to also make it something so heavy. It doesn't always have to be doom and gloom. Our spiritual journey is hard enough. Our physical journey is hard enough. This fucking journey is hard enough. Find ways that support you and make you feel empowered. This is why I go straight to sort of imagination and empowering the inner child, because when we empower the inner child, we don't have to think. We just feel. We're just playing. I'm flowing around, and you'll notice a big shift in my energy. Someone would come by and be like, gosh, this guy's just so all over the place. But instead, it's actually more flowing with what I feel in that moment. If my inner child's really active, then I'm real joyful and I'm really playful and I'm involved with that energy of the way it wants to work with the magic, instead of trying to resist it and guide it into a way that I want it present it, or that I want to receive it or perceive it, all of those aspects. So I'm going to continue here. Many people following the spiritual path do their darndest to stay away from what they call, what we call the shadow, until one learns that both sides, light and dark, that's a big word. They factor into the whole. All is lost in the search of truth. The Buddha speaks of the necessity of knowing the dark before one can become enlightened. Your journey here on earth is perhaps to experience everything, and that means the shadow too. When you experience a shadow aspect, resist not. Bring awareness into it and transform it. This is a true and priceless gift. In many ancient cultures, unless the healer has experienced the illness himself, he was not considered capable to heal the condition. If tribal children were traumatized, they were put through serious training to learn to face and transform the shadow. Usually they went on to become a gifted medicine person who helped others do the same. It is possible to transform your shadow, but first you need to understand what it is. The shadow side of self, which hinders growth, is constantly inviting you to transform it on a daily basis. Be they fears, negative thoughts, projections, harmful habits, or feelings of self-importance. Resisting your shadow prolongs suffering. Know in every shadow death, there is beauty unfolding, the birth of a new gift or talent. Do you hear the song that's playing too? Flowers by Miley Cyrus. The shadow medicine card brings great possibilities of transformation, forgiveness, wisdom, and understanding. Discovering your shadow can show you much about who you are not. The shadow also shows you your light. Goodbye, shadow. We done transmuting you. Can love me better. I can love me better, baby. Can love me better. I can love me better. Whoa. Okay, we're gonna read Freedom now. Woo! Alexa, skip. Okay. Sorry, Miley. I didn't want to hear two of your songs back to back. We're moving on from the... She was like getting angry again. I wanted... this deck right here is called the Mystic Art Medicine Oracle Cards. Tools for Transformation by Sherlyn. Mystic Art Medicine. Okay. Freedom. Venus, the goddess of sexuality. Goddess of sexuality, open and free, I stand apart, open heart, full of light, freedom, my divine birthright. In the painting of Venus, the goddess of sexuality, her arms are open to give love and receive all that the creator has for her. You notice that the last card was all he, and this is all her. So really, again, interesting and sort of incorporating those two dualistic energies here for us. Her hair spans out like the clouds, and her body is draped in the etheric cloak of light. Her essence and color reflect... Sorry, I'm trying to hold it for y'all, but this mirror mode makes it so hard. And then the light... And the light's kind of cool, though. It's like, ah. Okay. Her essence and color reflect the spirit of peace and freedom. She is surrounded by watery emotions and cosmos.
Didn't I talk about how the emotions were really high during the healing? You remember? And I said how it was very fitting because of the moon.
She is surrounded by watery emotions in the cosmos. She's under the full moon and the dark moon, all in one, indicating balance. In this watery world, she has learned to understand the realms of emotions. She stands as a silent witness in a place of equanimity.
That was the same word that I couldn't say, and now here I could say it, equanimity.
This composure, allows her to receive, and you notice how the feminine is so much more playful. This composure allows her to receive gifts that come forth from mastering emotions, rather than her emotions taking her in an undercurrent of destructive hard knocks. She stands in a place of freedom. Sexually, physically, emotionally, financially, spiritually, and in all ways, absolutely, motherfuckers. Which is it you are seeking? Freedom from sexual inhibitions, liberty from self-judgments, your childhood conditioning, and the opinions of others, free from unjustified fear, or how about total deliverance from it all? To give purposeful meaning and joy to your earthly life, you require freedom. Your nature is innately free. It has nothing really to do with anything you are doing or perceptions of good or bad. Freedom is your nature, and that nature is ever available to you. True freedom is a spiritual state. Your spirit is never bound or imprisoned. Know that you no longer have to please anyone, and you no longer need to fit in. You are only required to be you. When you are authentic, you love peacefully, passionately, and free. You will inspire people around you, and they will celebrate freedom with you. When you live in this way, you unfold into your liberated self, full of untamed, wild potential and joy.
And low battery, the moment that I said joy and I finished, low battery mode, 10%. My phone's at 10%.
Y'all, let's do a how. One, two, three. Night, 10 o'clock on the dot, and I said 10%, 10-10, major completion, major cycle closing. When I snap my fingers, everything is complete. We release, we alchemize, we transmute as necessary. We release anything not needed to Gaia, and we invigorate, and we take ourselves forward with love. Okay, y'all. I think I am going to wrap it up, but I want to give anybody an opportunity. I'm not going to do any messages, but anybody that wants a candle intuitively chosen for you, I will pick one for you right now quickly before I go. Just let me know in the chat. Give me your name, and I'll pick one for you, and I'll give you a quick small message of just how you could quickly apply it, but I'm not going to get into a message with it, okay? Thank you for being here. I hope the message resonated for you. Love you, Mama Double I. Man, I'm gonna sleep good tonight. I love it. Yes. Could I get a candle? Yes, Teal. Okay. And Letita, I will get you a candle as well, okay? So Teal, let's see. I think that is poignant here. Let's see. Oh, I actually love it. That is so cute. And it's the box of the month, Teal. So the rabbit. And I actually felt I saw a little curled up image. I don't have it over here anymore. Of like the two rabbits like together or something. Like I don't know, something very like lovey.
So maybe this is a call to take a self-care day or just to connect with Gaia even deeper. I mean, you're constantly doing so daily, so I feel like it has to mean something a little bit more nuanced, like about luck or about what you're building or something, an idea, because Rabbit is all about new ideas. And so and it's the year of seven, so luck, yeah. Rabbit's the first guide. And then La Tita, I believe. Letitia? I might not be saying your name correctly, and I apologize. Butterfly! I love it. New beginnings and growth. New beginnings and growth. And again, y'all, go read the messages on my website, because you can get the full message, and it's like a full download, because it's going to give you a message on where you are in your journey right now. So go read it. This is about new beginnings and growth. You actually get to choose the essential oil combo, but what I have gone with as the main oil combo for the butterfly is lemon and orange. I wasn't sure in the beginning. I almost went with the butterfly, but it ended up settling on lemon and orange for me being the main scent for the butterfly. But you can totally change it with to whatever you'd like. Same with any of my guides. You can choose the bear with a different one. Skip. Okay, who else wants a candle? Anybody else? Okay, could I please? Yes, let me see here. Yes, Shannon. Okay, yes. And then Bridget. Okay. Shay. Let me get you one, Shay. Let's see her. Okay. The Raven. Intelligence and mystery. Frankincense essential oil. I forgot that I had the violet flame on still, y'all. I literally forgot. And I'm getting here... There's something about a journal entry, so I don't know if you wrote a journal entry today or if there's something about a journal entry that you're going to find, and it's going to be like a little message that feels like a little piece of like knowledge that you, like, you know, sometimes we'll get downloads and like I am sad that I can't move on it because I really want to move on that download or like move on that idea. Okay, when I say download, I mean idea, like it could be like a creative idea or an inspired like movement or a vision of something. Like I, like let's say you see yourself, I don't know, running in a 5K, and like you're like, oh, I really would love to do that, but I wish the time, but you saw the whole image of the 5K, like spirit is gonna like, you wrote that idea down and now you're gonna find it, and it's gonna be like 5K, oh, I'm gonna sign up, that's right, I'm gonna sign up for that 5K this year, and it's gonna like line up. That's what I'm getting. And I almost like felt like story, something about a story. Yeah, okay, Bridget. Let us see, what does Bridget need? The moon! We're burning it tonight, love. The moon spirit guide, cycles and shadow, lavender essential oil. And I actually am feeling that if you have the moon, because I think you might, that they want for you to bring it into the shower with you or do something with water. Because again, the moon is really giving me like, it's giving me like Aquarius, like even though that's an air sign, it's giving me Aquarius, like something having to do with holding water barrels and pouring the water, like using our mind to nourish us, using our spirituality to soothe us and nourish us. Like, I don't know, Aquarius is coming up very vividly. So there could be something about taking some time out to plan something, or to follow a new journey. Like maybe you're all of a sudden interested in astrology or numerology and it's piquing your interest. So follow something that is like a trickle, that feels like a little inkling. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Cats up, yes. Let's see here. Elefante. The elephant. Harmony and balance. And I'm clearly hearing justice coming through, which I do look at this. They are a big signifier of justice for me. And this is rosemary and lemon essential oils. Love the elephant. Again, go read the messages on my website, spiritguideapothecary.com. Link is in the bio. Harmony and balance. But I'm getting that some sort of conversation or you're going to have an opportunity to like bring the gavel down, and spirit wants you to bring it down. Ah! Yes! I love it when they tell me that.
I don't be mean though, okay? Like there's the truth can be true, but it doesn't have to be cruel. So, but there's something where it's like you're gonna like, and I told you so moment, something like that, and it's gonna be very just, like, and it's gonna feel good in a lot of ways, but in the ways that were because you weren't sitting there casting judgment on that situation. So if it's over something where you've been constantly like not that you're being that way, but you know how we are as humans. I just mean like picking over like how it is, and you're like, well, fine, you know, this or that. I'm upset with it already, then it's not from that. It's something that was very clearly unjust and like you handled it really well, and it's gonna come back around, and spirit wants you to be like, yep, dunk, dunk, dunk. I'm literally getting Judge Judy. Like, if I was good at impersonations, I would have done a Judge Judy impersonation. Okay, Kylie, love taking cleansing showers. Love it. Okay, yay, cool. I will read the Raven. Yay, okay, cool. Me, please. Yes, Kylie, okay. I see, these quick ones are kind of like hot off the iron, so like I go with what it, like, take it with a grain of salt a little bit, okay? Because I am kind of like spatting out the reading to you just a little tiny bit. So I got deer for you and I got sea turtle, okay? So two of them here, and I actually kind of feel like this trio could be powerful, the sea turtle, the moth, and the deer. But just in general, calling their energies in, because never am I ever telling you to go purchase 3 candles, because you will do that if you feel called and you want to work with these guides in candle form. But what I mean is that resilience and divine timing, clarity and guidance of the moth, and I'm not going to take all 3 down. I am going to bring the deer down because it's the one I first saw. And then I went to the sea turtle, and then it was the moth. But clarity and guidance with the moth, which is patchouli and mint, pineapple and coconut for the sea turtle, and then lemongrass and lavender for the deer. Peace and serenity here. And I'm just getting, with both the deer and the sea turtle being like smushed in between, or like holding, sandwiching the moth, I'm getting that being gentle, like kids' gloves. Like if you were teaching someone how to tie their shoes, you wouldn't come out the gate. Like, oh, it's funny, it's coming from the last reading, kind of like frustration. Though you've tied shoes a million times and there's a lot of frustration, you may have taught someone how to tie their shoes a million times. It's like that moment where you're like recognizing that, okay, I am in a situation where I have done all the preparation. This is giving me like Hermione Granger coming into the term with like already knowing every lesson, you know, like I don't know why that's coming out so vividly. I love it. Like in the best way possible too. Like you're so prepared. Like I got this is a collective message actually, that I got recently as well, that, or not collective, but, it's come up a couple times with clients. So there's a collective of us, and especially if you've worked with me before, if you've been booking with me recently, something that is really closing out for us that are, have been working together over the last couple years now, is this, this like always being so prepared that we're farther ahead than the journey is. And I think that this is something that, has sort of followed us as a pattern in life. And this is coming to a close now. Like you're finally going to be as prepared as the journey, like not over prepared for the journey, not under prepared for the journey, but as prepared for the journey. Love it. So with that note, I will close it out. I love you all so very much. I hope that you enjoyed the first new evening in Spirit Guide Apothecary Shop and the healing. I know it was a little, I want to pop on this week because I want to chat with y'all a little more this week. So I'm going to pop on this week later on at some point. So check the Discord. If you're not a Discord person as well already, get to the Discord inside of the link in my bio, where you'll also find the links to my website. But join the Discord. Go to my website to read the messages of the candles. Or if you want an intuitive candle and I didn't get to pick one for you and you're wanting to purchase, just purchase the intuitive candle. I do have some orders to package up. I'm going to work in the candle shop tomorrow. So I'll package up some candles with y'all tomorrow in the candle shop, I think. So random time, I don't know yet. And it'll depend on if I am packaging candles in coffee mode or if I'm packaging candles in work mode. Two very different Alexes. and so sometimes I am not in the energy state to be perceived. So I can only perceive myself, and the candles are with me. Okay, thank you. Thank you all so much. Aw, thank you so much, y'all. I appreciate the love. I'm feeling the extra love this evening from y'all, and I love it. Thank you. Lots of that way. Aw. Wait. Wait, you finally completed the sale of the Nightmare property. Congratulations! What a great thing to close out for Mercury retrograde.
Cut the journal entry about my future property. Yeah.
Cut to the journal entry about the future property. I love it.
I'm looking back. Okay.
Okay, y'all. I love you all so very much. Thank you for the likes. 35,000 likes. Oh, gosh. The shop looks so cool. It's so big on here. I was just finally actually looking at it. I've just been looking at the chat. I mean, why am I showing you? You're actually looking at it. I'm like, look at it on this tiny screen now. Wow, trippy, trippy, trippy. So many trippy things have been happening like that. All right, I love you all. I will see you all next Sunday, the 30th, I believe. Holy, wow. The 30th of April. I will see you all on the 30th of April, but again, I'm going to pop on, so hit the notification bell in my profile, follow if you haven't already, and I'd love it if you'd follow me on Instagram, that would mean a lot, as well as on YouTube, if you like more long-formatted videos. I do readings and things like that that you can watch over on those platforms. So, and that way, if we lose TikTok, we can stay connected. I love you. Goodbye. And I'll see y'all soon.